Looking to streamline processes, reduce manual tasks, and get real-time updates on things that matter to you? Webhooks might be just what you need. In this video, we're going to look at what are webhooks, how they work, and why they might be a game changer for your business. Before we get started, let's make sure we're on the same page. What are webhooks? Well, in simple terms, webhooks are a way for one application to notify another application when something has occurred. For example, you have an e-commerce site and you'd like to be updated when someone places an order. Well, you can use webhooks to send that information to your accounting software or your customer relationship management tool, in real time, of course. Now, this will help automate processes, reduce errors, and improve your overall efficiency. Now, technical viewers out there might be wondering how webhooks differ from APIs. While APIs are a common way for applications to communicate, they require the receiving application to periodically poll the sending application for any new data. Imagine you're on a long road trip and the backseat passenger asks you every 15 minutes how much longer to go. On the other hand, with webhooks, the sending application initiates the communication when a particular event occurs. So the receiving application doesn't constantly have to ask for updates, which saves resources and provides more accurate and faster information. Before we dive into the technical details, let's take a look at the benefits of webhooks. Now, one of the biggest advantages of webhooks is that it provides real-time updates, which is going to be incredibly useful for applications that need immediate action, such as chat apps, communication tools, or financial systems. As we covered before, webhooks can be more efficient than APIs. And that's because webhooks only send data when it's needed, rather than requiring constant requests for information. Another benefit is that webhooks can be customized to suit your specific needs. For example, you can select what data is sent with an event, what triggers that event to send, and where that data will be received. It gives you a lot more flexibility and control over how you use your webhooks in your applications. Finally, webhooks are highly scalable. This means they can be used in applications that need to handle large volumes of data or traffic. By only sending data when it's needed, webhooks can help you reduce the load on your servers and ensure that your application remains responsive. Now, we've covered what webhooks are in theory, but how do we set them up in practice? To tell you the truth, setting up a webhook differs depending on the applications you're using. However, most products, particularly SaaS products, will have a settings or similar section where you can paste the webhook URL you've created. Now, while we can't cover every app on the internet, we can show you how to do this using Paperform. For our example, let's add our submitter to our CRM platform ActiveCampaign. Now, firstly, we need to collect the webhook URL for the end point application, the receiver, and that for this example is going to be ActiveCampaign. So applications should provide the URL somewhere within the platform. Try looking for a developer tab or section or something similar. I'm going to navigate to the developer tab by going to my ActiveCampaign settings where I can find developer and I can also find the URL. Now, depending on what data I want to share with ActiveCampaign will determine how the URL is configured. Platforms will have a developer or an integrations or an API help module that can provide you with further information on how you can do this. So jumping back into the form editor, navigate to After Submissions, Integrations and Webhooks, and click the Webhook section that you find further down the page to open its configuration. Select the input above the Add Webhook button and enter your endpoint URL. Click Add Webhook button to add your webhook to the list. You can now test that webhook by clicking the test button in the webhook section. This will trigger the webhook to send the latest submissions data. However, the test button will only work if you have submitted the form at least once. And that's because Paperform is going to need some real data to test the webhook with. Now, as earlier stated, the process of obtaining or creating the webhook URL differs depending on the application you use. But it's really quite easy once you have obtained your webhook to place it within your sending application. So we took a quick look at setting up a webhook in Paperform. And if you're still a bit confused about webhooks and how to set them up, not to worry because there are other methods when it comes to sending data from one application to another application. One of these we previously mentioned is using an API. Now, an API is a way for one software application to request information or perform actions from another software application. Similar to a webhook, however, a webhook is like getting notified when something happens, whereas an API is asking a question and then getting notified. Modern apps such as Airtable, Notion, and even Paperform have a publicly available API with tutorials to help you get up and running. Now, this could be easier because webhooks tend to take a lot more tinkering. If that sounds too technical to you, consider diving into the world of integration platforms. Companies like Make and Zapier offer pre-built integrations or connections so that you can easily share data across your applications. These are incredibly easy to set up and will take you a matter of minutes. So maybe you should think about doing that, as they are suited to people who are both technical and non-technical. Ultimately, the choice between webhooks or other integration methods will come down to your specific needs and the requirements of your project. It's true that using webhooks is a great option for real-time updates and automations, but other methods might be better suited to your particular use case. Now, using automation platforms like Make and Zap will definitely save you time because you don't need to write code nor create a server to receive that incoming data. For instance, you might use Zapier to automatically create a new task in your project management tool when someone completes your form, or even add a new contact to your CRM platform when someone completes your newsletter sign up. Now, alongside webhook support, Paperform offers a number of direct integrations, and it also natively connects with Make and Zapier, which expands your horizons to over 5,000 automation workflows. Now, if you're wondering where to get started, perhaps you should take a look at the Make vs. Zapier video that I've got linked above my head, or take a look at our channel for plenty of videos on our direct integrations. Well, I hope this has been a helpful video. If it has, smash that thumbs up button and subscribe to the channel for more helpful content. Good luck and have fun creating.